Hello students, we are in 12th lesson, that is World Between Wars. In our previous session, we have done about Hitler policies and the fascism Nazism policies and also Hitler Holocaust or the concentration camp method we have done in our previous session. Let us see in one point of view. One side Hitler was very bad and another side from the people point of view Hitler did certain public works. He was appointed Chalmers Chast. Chalmers Chast was an economist. He was appointed. Chalmers Chast was appointed for the public works purpose. Because you know that whenever Hitler came to power, he promised to the people that he will provide employment opportunities. So public funded industries were set up. Public funded industries were set up. Hitler gave all responsibility to Chalmers Chast for the economic progress. Yeah, Chalmers Chast used the public funds, and finally one of the most superb car those time, that is Volkswagen. So Volkswagen car production introduced very large scale, and many of the employees they worked. And not only this, but also a lot of armament factory means, you know, weapons, guns, all other war related products were increased during Chalmers Chast time. Volkswagen also introduced. This Volkswagen also called as people's car. It also called as people's car. Volkswagen also called as people's car. And before session we done that 6 million Jews were died, 2 lakhs gypsies were died, 10 lakhs other people were died, 70,000 Germans were handicapped. Those who are physically, mentally handicapped, they were euthanasia was given. Euthanasia means mercy killing. Hitler wanted to make the country very fit. So he doesn't want to see any handicap or physically, mentally challenged. Hence these members all were killed. Euthanasia means mercy killing. Now let us see reasons for world wars. Reasons for World War II. The period of World War is 1939 to 1945. Let us see few reasons. In our first session we have done that certain reasons are there. Both wars, aggressive nationalism, imperialism, secret alliances, militarism. But few more causes are there. Let us see first one, Treaty of Versailles. We knew that victorious countries, they are punished very harsh, and those countries they believed in a different ideology, for example Nazism and fascism. So that countries they wanted to take revenge. So Treaty of Versailles also one of the cause, because due to the Treaty of Versailles many people were humiliated, many countries were humiliated. So that Treaty of Versailles also one of the reason for World War, Second World War. Next one, Failure of League of Nations. Yeah, as you know that League of Nations was set up by Woodrow Wilson. Okay, League of Nations was set up by Woodrow Wilson. At the time 58 countries were joined, but USA did not join. Why USA didn't join? Because American Senate, that means American Parliament was not accepted to join in it. Hence it was not joined. Yeah. And moreover, League of Nations also set up with ICJ. ICJ means International Court of Justice. It also set up International Court of Justice. Yeah. Next, the main aim of this this League of Nations was collective security. Collective security. Most of the countries they felt that which countries were joined, they felt that League of Nations will be remove all the disputes through collective security. In initial days it was very good, but when Germany, Italy, plus Japan, they did not believe in League of Nations, they did not follow the guidelines of League of Nations, they were disobeyed the rules and regulations of League of Nations, hence there was Second World War broke. So League of Nations was failed. League of Nations did not prevent Germany, Italy, Japan to follow the rules and regulations of League of Nations. ICJ, International Court of Justice. ICJ, International Court of Justice, it is located in The Hague City, Netherlands. The Hague City, Netherlands. Next, sir. Third one. One of the third is German challenge. German challenge to vengeful domination. Vengeful means desired domination. Germany is desiring. Germany, during Hitler's time, they built a massive army, strong army. They enhanced their armaments, they enhanced their military. Hence, you know, Germany demanding that we lost territories during World War. We lost territories after the Treaty of Versailles. So we want that territories which we lost. So they are demanding for the territories which they were lost. Okay, next step, fourth one is fear from the socialism or fear of communism, socialism or Russia. Britain, France followed appeasement policy. What is appeasement? Yeah. Britain, France, they tried Hitler to do war against Russia. They are encouraging Hitler to fight against Russia so that they are pleasing, because Britain, France, these are European countries, and obviously Russia also, most probably it is located in Europe and Asia, but in Russia the government was different. So that these countries are pleasing Hitler to attack on Russia, because they are afraid that Russian kind of government, Russian kind of revolution may take place anytime in Europe. Hence, you know, they are encouraging, they are pleasing Hitler to go war fight with against Russian government. So that is called as appeasement. That is called as appeasement. And let us see last one. These are the reasons, and last one is immediate cause. What is the immediate cause? The immediate cause is on 1st September 1939. On 1st September 1939, Hitler attacked on Poland. For Danzig port. Yeah. When Hitler was attacked on Danzig port, Second World War began. Yeah, many countries, as in this again in this war, two blocks were fought. What are the blocks? We will see. So on September, immediate cause is on September 1st, 1939, Hitler attacked on Poland for the Danzig port. They want Danzig port purpose, he was attacking. Now let us see what are the consequences and how the countries were involved. So here, yeah, so these are Axis powers. This side, these are Axis powers, and these are again Allied powers. Here Germany, Italy, Japan. This side Britain, France, USSR and USA. And USA. So these are one side. And these people were one. So Allied powers were one. How many members they died? No. 20 to 25 million people were dying. 20 to 20 people. Enormous cost. See, in World War, this is World War 2. In World War 1, 10 million people were dying. 10 million people, 75,000 Indians were dying during World War. That means, you know, it was here double. It was double. Right. So, more than double, the members were died in the Second World War. Next step. USA did not join initially in this group. USA did not join. But in 1941, Japan attacked USS naval bases, which is called as Pearl Harbor. I repeat, this is Pearl Harbor. 1941, Japan, it was attacked USS naval base Pearl Harbor. America became very angry and finally USA joined. They may ask, why USA joined into Second World War? Because Japan drops bombs on Pearl Harbor, then America joined in the group of Allied group. Next step. Hitler was attacked in Russia. In this period again, Hitler attacked Russia. Hitler was attacked Russia in 1942, and there was a great defeat. It was the Germans were defeated. Mostly Germans were defeated. Later, Allied forces were entered into the Germany. Allied forces were entered into the Berlin. Finally, Hitler was committed suicide, and the war was end. So Germany was surrendered. Germany was surrendered into World War II, but Japan did not surrender. When 1945, USA drops bombs on Hiroshima Nagasaki. Yeah, when USA drops bombs on Hiroshima Nagasaki, Japan also surrendered. Finally, 1945, Japan also surrendered into the World War II. But after World War II, there was no any treaty. There is no any treaty was mentioned because of the Treaty of Versailles, only one war broke out. If again they thought that it is not good to punish, they thought, so did not go for that kind of treaty. But after the World War II, there were certain changes. What are the changes? Let us see. This is Germany. Okay? So Germany was divided into two parts. One part is called as GDR. GDR. GDR means German Democratic Republic. It was under the control of USSR. And one more is FRG. Okay? Federal Republic of Germany, it was under the control of USA. So here the Berlin War was constructed. Federal Republic of Germany. Germany was divided into two parts. USA block. USA supported FRG. USSR supported GDR. Next up. Japan. What happened to Japan? After the defeat, Japan became constitutional monarchy country. Constitutional monarchy. And the Japan parliament is called as Diet. Okay, those persons are responsible for the huge Holocaust. Those persons were responsible for the huge Holocaust of Germany. They were prosecuted by the International Tribunal. By the International Tribunal, also called as Nuremberg Tribunal. So Nuremberg Tribunal punished, sentenced 11 Nazi leaders. 11 Nazi leaders were sentenced to death. Okay, so Nuremberg tribunals were sentenced to 11 Nazi leaders. 11 Nazi leaders were died. So after this, they did not punish. Just now I said, victorious countries, they did not punish any of the losers or those who are defeated in the hands of them. But instead of that, they are giving helping hand. They are promoting. They are promoting economical sanctions, especially USA. USA introduced Marshall Plan. Those countries were worst hit by the war. Those countries were suffered a lot by the war. So for the country they wanted to help, you know, they introduced Marshall Plan. Marshall Plan is introduced by USA to help the countries, those who are very badly affected due to the war. Next, after this, UNO. We know that UNO, United Nations Organization. United Nations Organization was formed. It was formed 1945, October 24 it was formed. The main aim of the United Nations Organization is, first one, preserve peace. Second one is uphold human rights. Third important one is respect international law. Fourth one, promote social progress. So these are the main aims. United Nations Organization. It has certain branches also. It has, you know, certain organs like UNESCO, United Nations Educational Scientific Cultural Organization, UNICEF, United Nations International Children Emergency Fund, United Nations International Children Emergency Fund, WHO, and WTO, ILO. Certain organizations are works under the United Nations Organization. In United Nations Organization, 193 countries are present. There are 193 countries are there in present in United Nations Organization. Yeah, after the World War, two countries became powerful. Before that, Britain was very powerful. But after the war, Britain lost its rank. Britain lost its colonies. Britain lost its rank. So finally, USA and USSR became superpowers. So war was made them superpowers. And USSR influenced Eastern Europe. USSR influenced Eastern Europe, and most of the Eastern Europe was under the control of socialism. They adopted socialism. So that we can say that socialist camp. Many of the Eastern European countries, example, this is European countries. So this is Russia. Those countries are near to Russia. These all countries, they adopted socialism. Means they are also adopted communist parties. And after these two powers, there was a domination, we have learned. Okay, next, enfranchisement. Enfranchisement of women. Women were started to fight against of the enfranchisement. Enfranchisement means, you know, voting rights. During that time, there was no voting rights for women. Women, hence, you know, these women were starting for adult suffrage or feminism. It also called as feminism, or voting rights movement was started by the women. And finally, Britain women, they got right to vote. Before that there was no right to vote. Britain women, they got right to vote in 1918. Britain women got right to vote in 1918. Britain lost its ranking. Britain lost its ranking. Finally, many countries after 1950 or during 1950s, during 1950s, many countries were got independence, like India, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, Malaysia, Pakistan. So these all countries in 1950s, many countries got independence. Okay, let us see these differences between World War One and Two. You see, World War One. I said to you, 10 million people were died. 10 million in World War One and World War Two. 20 to 20 million people were died because of enormous increase of weapons and armaments. Whenever these armaments and these all are increased, so due to that, you know, the death rates also increased. Okay. World War One, after the major changes. After the Treaty of Versailles, many new countries came. Example, I told to you, Austria, a new country was formed. Hungary, a new country was formed. Okay, Hungary, new country was formed. Estonia, new country was formed. Okay, Czechoslovakia, new countries were formed. These new countries were, because of the formation of these new countries, again world map was redrawn. Redrawn because in the world map they have to locate the places. Then again in Second World War, world map was redrawn. Again in Second World War, the world map was redrawn because many ex-colonies means, you know, India, Sri Lanka, Indonesia, in most of the African countries. Most of the African countries, they got independence. Yeah, when they got independence. Yeah, when they got independence. So again, their countries also, they clearly mentioned in the, Europe map, and in world map. Then again, redrawn. So this is our lesson. This is our world between wars. We have done from the beginning. You have to understand only one thing. Sometimes they may ask you that what are the reasons, immediate reasons for the World War One and World War Two. Just you simply have to follow this method. You write as here World War One, 1914 to 1939. Sorry, 1914 to 1918. Here World War Two, 1939 to 1945. Yeah, immediate cause they are asking. So immediate cause was, yeah, Archduke Franz Ferdinand. Simple. Ferdinand was assassinated. By a Bosnian Serb. Yeah, Bosnian Serb. So Ferdinand was, you can write also Heir Prince or Archduke Prince of Austria, Austro-Hungarian, on 28th June 1914. Yeah, war started on 28th July 1914. Okay, countries. You see the countries here, yeah, Central Powers, right? Central powers here, allied powers. So these are Germany plus Italy plus Austria, Austro-Hungary plus Turkey. So these are the countries: Germany, Italy, Austria, Turkey. Here Britain, France, Russia, USA. So these countries they won. And again, they were 10 million people were died. 10 million people they died, and including 75,000 Indians. And moreover, here you have to mention that Treaty of Versailles. Then again, you know that IMC. IMC means immediate cause. Hitler attacked Poland. Hitler attacked on Poland. Hitler attacked on Poland. On what date he was attacked? On 1st September 1939. On 1st September 1939, Hitler attacked Poland. Again, yeah, here. Blocks. Or else you better to write the blocks same to same. It is better to do not confuse, we may not confuse. Here we are calling as Axis powers. Axis powers. And here again we are calling as Allied powers. So this is the difference they may ask. What is the difference? Here again, Germany, Italy plus Japan. Here, France, Russia, Britain plus US. So these are. Who won? These were won. How many people were died? 22 to 25 million people were died. So here, League of Nations was set up. Okay, League of Nations set up. Here, United Nations Organization was set up. So these are, in this manner, we have to write. World War I, World War II. Reasons for this all. Reasons for this all, again we have to write as aggressive nationalism. Aggressive nationalism. Second one, imperialism. Third one, secret alliances. Fourth one, militarism. So these all are the causes. And Great Depression also very, very important. Treaty versus terms and conditions also very, very